Hello YouTube, what's up? So today I have decided to make a video about the best books to read for the anesthesiology residents during their residency. Yeah, so without wasting much time, let's get started. All right, so first and foremost, I would like to recommend this book, Gestalting Pharmacology and Physiology. Guys, this book brushes up your knowledge of pharmacology and physiology. It's really an amazing book to study after entering into the anesthesia residency during your first post-graduation year. It pretty much brushes up all your knowledge which you have learned in the med school. So basically, I would say this book is like a prerequisite before you start reading the clinical anesthesiology. All right. So the next book I would like to recommend is Clinical Anesthesiology by Morgan and Michael. Guys, this is an excellent book for clinical anesthesiology. It is loved by many people and it is easy to understand. It's a short book and it is easy to learn. I personally love reading this book. Okay, so while we are talking about clinical anesthesiology, the next book I would like to recommend is Stolting's Anesthesia and Coexisting Disease. Guys, this is an excellent book. This is a 7th edition. It's a fantastic book. It covers all the diseases and surgeries, the anesthetic management from every small disease to the largest surgery that is available. It is an amazing book. Highly recommended. Highly recommended. Okay. So moving on to the next book, it is the Miller's Anesthesia. It is a Miller's Anesthesia. It is like a Bible for anesthesiologists. It is an excellent resource if you want to dive in deep into the subject. It has everything right from the basic pharmacology and physiology to the recent updates and the guidelines. Yeah, so if someone asked me to select only one book, yeah, that would be Miller's Anesthesia. All right. So, ouch. The next book I would like to recommend to the clinical anesthesiology is Paul G. Barash. Barash is an excellent book. It's an excellent book. Now coming to neurosurgery, I would like to recommend Cottrell and Partel's Neuroanesthesia. This is the 6th edition of Neuroanesthesia textbook. It is an excellent book. It covers all the core concepts of anesthesia related to neurosurgery. It is highly recommended during the neuroanesthesia postings or neuroanesthesia rotation. It is a perfect book for those who really want to dive in deep into the neuroanesthesia. It's Cottrell's. Alright, so the next book I would like to recommend is Obstetric Anesthesia by Chestnuts. It is a fantastic book. It is a must read during your obstetric rotation. And it's probably like the Bible for those who want to pursue their career in obstetric anesthesia. Alright, so if you are someone who is keen about cardiac anesthesia or you want to pursue or prepare for cardiac super specialty, then I would highly recommend this book, The Kaplan's Cardiac Anesthesia. This is a fantastic book. It covers all the core cardiac anesthesia. Yeah, so if you are interested in cardiac super specialty, then this book is for you. All right, so the next book which I would like to recommend is Anesthesia for Infants and Children by Smith. So this is an excellent book, guys. If you are interested in pediatric anesthesia, then this is definitely a recommended book for you. All right, so the next book I would like to recommend is Airway Management by Benimoff. This book was recommended to me by one of my professors. This is an excellent book for airway management, guys. It has everything, every information you need to know about airway management in both children as well as adults. It's an excellent book. highly recommended. So the next book I would like to recommend is Introduction to Electrocardiography by Leo Szamrow. I would recommend this book during your first month of residency because it is very important to read the ECGs and know the abnormalities during the preoperative evaluation or the pre-anesthetic checkup of any patient posted for surgery. Yeah, so it is a must read for all the anesthesia residents, especially the first year residents. It's a quick read and easy to understand. Yes, it's a solid book. It's a very productive book. So, for the regional anesthesia, I would recommend you to read Collins Regional Anesthesia, The Principles of Anesthesiology by Collins. It is an excellent book. It covers everything from the basics to the high-end concepts in the regional and general anesthesia. It is a must-have for every anesthesia resident. And there is another book called Regional Anesthesia by Prithvi Raj, which I personally did not read, but it is also given in the MCI website as a recommended book in the part of curriculum of the anesthesia. There is another great source for reading about the regional anesthesia. That is NYSORA. NYSORA is nothing but the New York School of Regional Anesthesia. It is a fantastic website for nerve blocks. It gives you everything A to Z about the nerve blocks. It is an excellent resource for learning nerve blocks. Well, now moving on to the next set of books, I would like to recommend four books for those who have just started their ICU rotation or those who want to pursue their career in critical care medicine. These four books are The ICU Book by Paul Marino, The Washington Critical Care Manual, The Pilbeam's Mechanical Ventilation, and Chang's Mechanical Ventilation. Yes, all these four books are fantastic. They are helpful for those who are preparing for critical care entrance or those who want to pursue their career as a critical care physician. And these books are perfect and they have all the basics which are related to critical care medicine as well as all the ventilator basics and to the recent advances which are necessary and including the newer modes of ventilation. Everything is perfect. These books are really awesome. Highly recommended. Must read, guys. So, and yeah, there are many other books which I'm not a big fan of, but most of my friends do read these books, like The Lee Synopsis of Anesthesia, The Longneckers Anesthesiology by McGraw-Hill, and there is a book on pain management by Raj. So yeah, people do read these books. And also there are various journals to learn about the recent updates and update your knowledge on the recent guidelines. These journals, we can list it out as British Journal of Anesthesia, Indian Journal of Anesthesia, IJA, European Journal, the Canadian Journal, Journal of Cardiothoracic and Vascular Anesthesiology, Journal of Neurosurgery and Anesthesiology, Journal of Intensive Care Medicine, Regional Anesthesia and Pain Medicine. And there are many other journals which you can use to update your knowledge, and you can subscribe to their journals. And so, I think that is it. That's a whole lot of books. So if you like the video, let us know. If you don't like the video, let us know. So you don't forget to subscribe to our channel. And yeah, let's meet in the next video.